this video, we're going to be going over FileMaker Cloud, which is Claris's newest cloud product. We're going to be going over how to set that up, how to configure it, and some considerations that you may have if you're considering migrating over to this new product. So without further ado, let's get started. Now, FileMaker Cloud is best suited for those who are new to the FileMaker platform. And that's because FileMaker Cloud is a bundle of services. You're getting your licensing and your server hardware all wrapped up into one. And that is, of course, really appealing to those who don't necessarily have the server hardware or the resources or the IT staff in order to manage all that for you. So that being said, this does still apply to those who are sick of managing their server hardware, their server software, maybe their backups. FileMaker Cloud is really going to help with that as well. It means that all of that is taken care of and you don't have to worry about making these IT decisions. It's going to keep you motivated, it's going to keep you moving, and it's going to keep you innovating. Let's say you have an existing app that you do want to migrate over to FileMaker Cloud. The first things that you do want to consider are WAN performance issues. So some apps will work just fine locally, but if you put them on the WAN, they will not necessarily perform very well and you will see some dips in performance. So if you're not entirely sure what that means, you can go ahead and contact us at DB Services and we'll be able to evaluate your application and tell you if it's up to snuff for that. As well, you'll want to make sure that you aren't using server-side plugins and that that comes with the FileMaker Cloud platform being a platform as a service. They do have some considerations that are going to pare everything down and make setup, in the process, make setup easier. So you also want to make sure you don't have custom web publishing using PHP or XML. And if you want a full list of all the requirements and considerations, you can go ahead and read the article on our website. Now, before we do get started, I do want to mention that I've already gone through the purchasing process, and in order for you to do that, you can just go ahead and navigate over to store.filemaker.com, and then you can select the first option should be FileMaker Cloud. You can go ahead and roll through that. It's a pretty quick and easy setup, so I figured we'd go through this instead. So let's go ahead and sign in with my FileMaker ID. If you don't have that, you can log into my.filemaker.com and sign up for one. Your FileMaker ID is essentially your user associated with your specific email. So there's my email right there. We're going to go ahead and sign in. And then FileMaker ID automatically comes with two-factor authentication. So I've already set that up on my phone. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that code in there. All right, so now we are in our cloud console. So as you can see here, we've already set up our cloud server. And so we have two servers here. So I'm just going to go ahead and go to our newest one that we just set up. We're going to go ahead and get started. So our old one was DB Services Temp. We're going to go ahead and do DB Services. And this is just requesting for a host name. If it's not available within that 24 hours, then FileMaker will let you know, and then you'll have to request a different host name. They just need unique host names for that. All right, so off the bat, it's gonna walk you through the setup, make sure that you've got everything, all your ducks in a row there. So I already have FileMaker Pro installed on my machine, but if you didn't, you'd go ahead and download the license certificate, and then go ahead and download FileMaker Pro 18 Advanced. All right, so as you can see here, we're still waiting for that host name to process. So let's go ahead and do some user management. So right now, I have two people on my team. So if I wanted to go ahead and invite a new person, go ahead and just add invite new user, it's very simple. We can just go ahead and type in their email. We have the option of adding them as licensed user or adding them as a team manager. I'm going to go ahead and add this this person on my team as a team manager, but you don't have to. Next, I'm going to go ahead and add a data entry user. I'm just going to use my personal email. And I've already went through and added an FMID for my personal email. So now we can go ahead and add a group for those. So typically you're going to be seeing administrator group and a data entry group. There we go. Let's create a data entry group as well. And this is pretty flexible, so you can add as many groups and as many users to those groups as you need. So I'm going to go ahead and put these. And of course, you can only do it one by one. And I'll get into the nuances of why groups are just so immensely important, and they're going to make user management so much easier. All right, so we have two administrators and one data entry user. Now let's see if this is, if I'm getting anything in here. There we go. So I just got this invitation to join. So I will need to sign out. Let's just go ahead and do this so I don't have any caching. Now I can sign in as my personal FMID. Right now I'll go ahead and sign in. And we're going to get the same sort of deal here. All right, so now that I'm here, this is basically all that I can see, which is great because I am not a, I'm not a team manager. So I can go ahead and if there was an app here, I'd go ahead and access it that way. And that is about it. So let's go ahead and go back to the team manager view. So as you can see here, we have a lot more options. We have user management and we have some hosts and settings. So hosts is just going to show you what your URL is right here. Let me switch over to the correct one. There we are. You can go ahead and navigate to the admin console right here. So nice and neat. You've got almost everything at your fingertips. This admin console is pretty much the same as FileMaker's on-prem or on cloud. A little more similar to FileMaker Cloud for AWS. So if you're familiar with that, that is a good starting point. Then we have settings. So for example, I can turn off this ability to download software. And then if I go to my other user and refresh the page, they should not be able to download. Let's see here. All right. Now, you can in this case convert our trial over to a full-on FileMaker Cloud yearly subscription. You can go ahead and add new users if need be, and really just manage the subscription as a whole. Also access your downloads right here. So, like I said, pretty much everything is at your fingertips in this console. So now that we've added users and groups, we're going to go ahead and take our app, add those groups to the app, and then upload it to this server. So I just have a local app right here that I'm going to go ahead and open up. There we are. All right. So we have a few users in here, but we don't have any FileMaker ID users in here. So because I'm logged in as my FileMaker ID and I have access to two servers, I can actually see groups in both of those servers. So this is the one that we just set up. I can go ahead and add either a new group or even an individual user. As you can see here, we have groups and users specifically. I'm just going to go ahead and add administrator, and I'm going to give that administrator full access. So if you notice, it's pretty clear how pretty evident how powerful this can be. It's pretty similar to account management tools such as Active Directory or Open Directory. And this is going to enable you to do user management on the FileMaker Cloud console instead of having to, if you have a multi-file solution, having to manage users in every single file in your FileMaker system. All right, and that's it. Now it's ready to be uploaded. And I'm just gonna copy and paste that right here. Looks like that request already went through. Oh, you know what? It looks like it's already there, which is also another powerful use of FMID. It's automatically synced to your user. And here we are. So now I am logged in under my FMID. A big thing to note is that FMID is only compatible with 18.0.3 and up. So if you're using FileMaker Cloud, you'll need to make sure that you update all your users to that version. So that's basically about it. If we decide that that should, I believe I accepted. We may have to refresh that. Well, if when your user does accept, if you decide that they don't, you don't want them to be licensed, but you still want to keep them on your team, say for example you have a contractor who you just want to give temporary access to, but you don't want them to count as your towards your licensing anymore, you just go ahead and remove them as a licensed user. So the invitation is still pending. They're still on your team, and you can actually relicense them at a later date, so you don't have to keep sending invites all the time. And then you can quickly check your licensing, how many people are available. So anyone who is going to be accessing your app, whether that's a developer or a regular end user, they will need to be licensed. That is pretty much about it. Once you get your app up there, you can access it from here. But yeah, I mean, that all of that really comes together to show that FileMaker Cloud is a really integrated and a well thought out a platform. It's really easy to set up a new server. It's really easy to get your app up there, and it's really easy to manage your users.